with that, guys, recovering properly, what about Mr. McDavid of the Oilers hitting his chin on the ice and they take him off for precautionary measures? Give me the version on that. What do you guys think of that? Perry?
I think he had a concussion, and I thought,
really?
in my view, I thought he broke his jaw.
He didn't want to come off at all.
And come on, man. I don't agree with that at all. I think that he didn't even get cut. Come on.
So you don't think that jarred him a little bit when he hit his chin? I mean, the number one place, Phil, you know better than anybody, the number one place when you're boxing is you punch somebody in the jaw on the bottom, because all the blood vessels, they join there, and it cuts the blood off from the head, and that's what causes them to, you knock them out. And you don't think that he got jarred when he hit his chin?
Of course he got jarred, but it wasn't. But that's what they do nowadays. They took him off.
I like it, Phil. I truly, truly, truly like that they did that, especially whether it's McDavid or anybody. I think it's you got the player's health and best interest at heart.
I'm going to tell you, it was because McDavid. That was specifically because of him. If they had not, they erred on the side of caution, is what I'm saying, because it was McDavid.
Right. He didn't want to come off, and the Oilers fans are going, what? What? But there are rules, and they got to abide by them.
I think they did the right thing. Yeah. You know, it might have fucked up the energy of the game, but I think they did the right thing.
Yeah.
Well, he was back, what, 5 minutes later or something?
Well, he had to sit out the whole second period.
Yeah, but you're right, Frank. It was the right thing to do.
But...
because if you didn't do that and something happened, they'd get criticized all
over. Well, you're fucking damned if you do, or you're damned if you don't. And I think, you know, we're at the point now where criticism, like Phil was saying at the beginning of him coming on the show, you know, the you get scrutinized, especially in Edmonton, by the press. Edmonton's another micro media, you know, that's the big Edmonton Eskimos and the Edmonton Oilers are their bread and butter. And that's what sells newspapers still.
And brand new arena.
They're a franchise on the rise. McDavid has a hell of a chin.
Yeah.
Nothing like that. Right. He hit his... Phil, has that ever happened to you, that you bang your chin like that, like nothing happened? I'm surprised.
And kept playing.
Didn't lose any teeth. Didn't get jarred.
He had a mouth guard. He bit on a mouth guard, but it looked to me when he hit, he could have broke his chin.
Right.
I mean, the fucking ice in Edmonton is hard as a fucking rock.
Right. But, Phil, you'd go on and stay on for three or four lines. They just keep changing your wingers, right?
Well, sometimes I got carried away.
Yeah, but Phil, guys were different. You guys knew how to fall. You guys had no fucking helmets, and you guys knew, when you guys fell, how to protect your fucking head. They don't do that now.
You're very, very young on how to protect yourself and brace your neck and everything else. We learned that.
Yeah.
They don't teach that anymore, and that's just the way it is. And I don't understand why. I think it's because of the equipment. Everybody thinks that you got all this equipment so you can't get hurt.
Yeah.
So you hit the fucking nail on the head. And I want to talk about that the next time, on how they're not training. They are not training the youth, the future hockey players, how to protect themselves, because they think that this false sense of protection with equipment.